My house was broken into last week. The police can identify the culprit from blood found at the scene. How can they do that? To understand this, we need to state what is meant by DNA fingerprinting and describe some uses of DNA fingerprinting. The burglar smashed a window, leaving blood on the broken glass. Samples of blood, hair, or skin can be collected from a crime scene. Forensic scientists investigate the samples in a lab. First, they extract DNA from the cells. They use enzymes to cut the DNA into shorter fragments. The fragments are placed into a well in a gel. They are separated using an electric current. Different sized fragments travel different distances in the gel. The smallest fragments travel the furthest. A pattern of bands is produced. This can be compared with the patterns of DNA from possible suspects. The enzymes cut different people's DNA in different places, producing a different set of fragments. The different sets of DNA fragments will produce different patterns of bands when separated on a gel. Each person has unique DNA, which will produce a unique pattern that can be used to identify them. If two patterns match, the samples are from the same person. So, the police are able to identify the man who burgled my house using his unique DNA fingerprint. They make a DNA fingerprint by taking a sample of cells from someone and separating fragments of DNA to make a pattern. If the pattern matches a sample from a crime scene, that person was there.